boys and girls. Do you want what type of hat's this here? It's a bike helmet, of course it is. We're going to learn a little bit about mountain biking with Dave and Archie today. Yes, so you can imagine flying around this corner here. Although that's for a railway track, but they love riding in the forest, on the paths. You never know, we might see them. But let's sing a song, All My Life. Here we go.
We've come across David here. David's really into mountain biking. David, how are you?
Not too bad, are you?
When I was a wee boy, we had a wee bike called a BMX. That looks like a motorbike. What is it?
It's a mountain bike. A wee bit more heavy duty than the BMX.
Wow, even the tires are like Land Rover tires. Absolutely massive. What sort of bike is that?
It's a Vitus mountain bike.
A Vitus?
Vitus mountain bike, yeah.
And where, do you normally just ride it around your yard here?
No, we take it up into the hills and the forests and stuff and try and find some jumps and trails to go down.
Oh, so there is purpose-made trails
and
jumps?
Oh, yeah. Loads and loads, yeah.
And why do you wear a helmet if you have cold, your ears cold?
It keeps my ears warm, but if I fall on my chin, it saves my teeth and my face.
You.
Yeah, protects my head.
So. And the gears on the mountain bike?
And there's 11 on the back and just a single on the front on this bike.
Yes. And so, suspension, does it have a suspension?
Yeah, some mountain bikes have front and back. Mine just has front suspension on it.
What's the idea of a suspension?
Just to make it less rattly when you're going down a bumpy trail, just to make it a bit more comfortable.
And David, you're a Christian.
Yep.
Is that important for you?
No, very important, yeah.
You have two sons.
Two sons, yeah.
Are they following in your footsteps?
They're trying to, aye. Yep.
Archie's gonna go for the jump. This is Archie. What age is Archie, David?
Archie's five.
5 year old Archie training to go for jumps here. Whoa! Why is it important to wear a safety helmet or a crash helmet, David?
Because your head's very, very important.
Is every time Archie be tempted not to wear his hat?
Yeah, sometimes when he can't be bothered wearing it, but you're better safe than sorry.
All right, Archie. That's the sort of bike I'm looking for. Is that too wee for me? What sort of bike is this, Archie? Do you know? A mountain bike, isn't it? What's these here?
Brakes.
What's the brakes for?
Slowing down.
Slowing down or stopping, that's right. You need brakes. Why are brakes important, David?
If you're going mountain biking, you might be going fast, and you need brakes to stop in case you come up against a tree or you see something in your way and you need to stop quickly.
And what lesson would you apply mountain biking in the Christian life, David, for you?
I suppose you need to be prepared. If you're on a mountain bike, you need to be prepared if something happens or something unexpected comes, and you need to be prepared to wear your helmet and your armour to protect you in case you fall off. And I suppose in the Christian life, if we don't have the Lord in our hearts as our Saviour, we don't have that protection, the devil can get at us. And eventually, when we come to die, if we don't have him as our protection and as our Saviour, then we can go to a lost eternity.
And what are the gear? You talked about gear. What gear do you wear, boots? Or just what you're
eating? I have boots and knee pads, gloves that I usually wear. So you need all suited up before you hit the trails.
I notice you have lots of patches. Does Amy, does your wife fix your trousers?
No, she doesn't fix my trousers at all.
Very good. So are mountain bikes expensive, David?
They can be, yeah. Yeah, you can spend anywhere from £400 or £500 up to £10,000-£15,000.
£1,000 for a bike? And what's the difference between a cheaper one and a more expensive one?
Mostly the higher up you go, they just get lighter and lighter and lighter.
And Dave, whenever you get on a trail on the mountain bike, is it hard on your arms or your legs, or what part of the body is it?
Most of your body.
Most of it?
Yeah.
Do you need a train to do that?
Yeah, you need to be warmed up and ready before you couldn't just hit a mountain bike trail when you're cold. You should need to be all warmed up and stretched, you know, before you start.
Because you're too tense otherwise?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
You'd hurt yourself more easily.
Have you ever fallen off?
Yep.
It does happen even
now. Oh, it does happen, yeah.
And would you get hurt?
I've hurt a couple of times, but a couple of scars to prove it.
And David, what's the idea of a mud guard?
Stop the muck going into my eyes.
And why is it on the back?
I don't have any eyes in my back, so I don't mind if I get dirty on my back.
Oh, so you will get dirt?
Yeah, you'll get very muddy.
That's great. And what have you talked about mountain biking? Is there all different, is it just one course for everyone, or is it different levels?
There's different levels. You usually start out, at the very start there's green trails, which you could walk on or cycle on, and then you have blues, which are a wee bit faster and maybe a few bumps on them. Then you go up to red. Red might have a few wee jumps and rocks, but anybody could ride over them if they wanted to.
Uh-huh.
And then once you go to black and orange, there's maybe things in the trail that you can't get over unless you jump them. So if you can't jump them, you shouldn't be on it, you know?
Yeah. So that's a little bit like the Christian life. The Bible talks about when a person is a Christian, starts off on their journey with God, they're drinking milk of the basic things in the Christian life. But as you go on with God and develop, the Bible talks about meet the deeper things of God. And it's like riding a bike. You start off riding with maybe the stabilizers, then you're off to do little jumps. Then when you're a man, an adult, more experienced, or a teenager, you want the big jumps and enjoy the big thrills. But there's always dangers. Speed a danger, David?
Yeah, that's why you need good brakes to stop or kill your speed when you're coming into a corner.
Would you need to service your bike often?
Yeah, you need to make sure it's nice and clean after each ride and all the dirt and grime out of it.
Why is that?
Just because the dirt can get into your gears and get into your brakes and stop them from working as well.
That's an amazing lesson. The dirt, sometimes when you come back home, you're tired, you maybe couldn't be bothered to wash your bike or clean your bike, but the dirt gets in, it's going to affect the mechanism or how the bike actually works. That's a little bit like sin in life. Sometimes we do something wrong, and even though we know we should tell God we're sorry or apologize to the person we've done wrong to, we think we'll just leave it for another day. But that starts festering and growing within your heart. And that's why the big picture of the Christian life is whenever you sin, we're to confess our sin before God and tell him we're sorry. And it gives you a new start, a clean start to go on in the Christian life. That's a really good lesson, David, isn't it?
Good job, yep.
But David, you're also a father, you've got two children, you've got a job,
uh-huh,
and you help out with the boys again in your local church, but you've still time to ride your mountain bike.
Sometimes not as much as I would like, but yeah, we do get time. So every couple of two or three weeks maybe we get out.
But if you could get more time, you would take more time?
Probably, yeah.
You obviously enjoy what you do.
Oh, it's great, yeah. It's good fun.
But Dave, it's not like the Christian life. You must enjoy the Christian life.
Oh, aye. The Christian life is always enjoyable if you have God with you and He makes life fun.
And He protects you. Do you feel do you ever pray when you're going down the slope? Or is it too late when you fall off?
It's probably too late by the time you've fallen off. But sometimes we would go out as a big group of fellas, you know, and up the hills in the forest. And one of the fellas who comes with us, he would stop us before we hit the trails. And he'd say, right, boys, we're going to stop and we'll pray. And he'll, you know, bring it before God before we go. And
prayer's not just about going to church, it's also everyday life as
oh,
well.
Oh, yeah, surely, yeah.
And you feel God does be with you and help you? And
oh, aye, if you ask Him to, and he'll keep His hand upon you. Sometimes you can still make mistakes, but
whether a little Archie on a small ramp at home or David on a faster course in the forest park, whether you're a businessman, a farmer, or a child at school or a teacher, the lesson's simple. When you walk with God, you've got to talk with God, and that's the same when you're riding a bike. Very, very good. That's an off-the-road bike, David, not so much
yep.
a road bike.
Yep.
Yeah, so different lessons, of course, when you're riding on the road, to be careful, but always wear your hat and be careful because there's big tractors and cars, fast cars. David, I really appreciate your time today.
No problem.
And seeing your lovely bike, and I'm glad it's nice and clean as well. And I'm glad your wife fixed your wee patches.
I know. I need to get on to her with that.
Okay, David, thank you. See you later, kids.
See you later.
Thank you, Dave. Thank you, Archie, for those jumps. And Dave is telling us how the different places he might go. And one of those places is in the mountains, the forest in the mountains, where they have to put on their gear, where they're helmet especially, and their pads, get on their bike, and off they go up into the mountains. I wonder, can they ride the bike in the snow? Let's have a look to see if we can find them. My God is powerful.
Yeah.
Dave Archie and family. Thank you so much, Dave, for teaching us about the safety of riding a mountain bike and the importance of exercise and especially of wearing a helmet to keep your head safe. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching and we'll catch you next time. Bye. Yeah, 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 yeah.